Vakratunda Mahakaya Surya Koti Samaprabha Nirvignam Kuru Medeva Sarva Karyeshu Sarvada Saraswati Namastubhyam Varade Kamarupini Vidyarambham Karishyami Siddhir Bhavatu Me Sada Gurur Brahma Gurur Vishnuhu Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha Guru Deva Param Brahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. A king was passing through another kingdom where there lived a well-to-do Persian king. And the custom was when you pass through a kingdom, you always go to greet that king, but never empty-handed. So he thought, what can I give to someone who has everything? And he brought two rare eagles that are not native to that country, to that land. And when he greeted the king, then he gave him these two eagles. And that king was so happy that I can have everything, but this I couldn't have got. And he expressed his appreciation. This king who was gifted these eagles, he brought them to the trainer of the kingdom, the animal trainer, and he said, these young eagles, make them soar high. And so the trainer got to work. And every day the trainer would work with both eagles. But only one of the eagles, wings was growing stronger, was attempting to fly. For the other one, there was no change. Every day the king would go and check up on these eagles. He was very fond of them. And after a month, the one eagle began to fly, and the other one would not leave its perch. This concerned the king and asked, he told the trainer to work harder, work smarter. So he tried different techniques, different strategies. But still, that eagle wouldn't take off. This frustrated the king. So he sent word to everyone in the kingdom who works with animals to find a way to get this second eagle to fly like the first one. So different people came with ideas, techniques, food, drink, etc. Nothing was working. And this king got so attached to these eagles that the one that wasn't flying was shaking his mind. And one day he was very sad and he was just looking out his window and he saw two eagles flying very high in the sky. And he was so happy and he runs out to where those eagles are kept and the trainer was there. He said, you got both eagles to fly. How did you do it? And the trainer said, it wasn't me, it was this farmer that knows about these eagles. And he turns to the farmer, what did you do to get this second eagle to fly? King, what I did was cut the branch that it was sitting on. Then it had no choice but to fly. The question here is, which eagle are you? Are you the first eagle that is proactive? Are you the second eagle that is reactive? That perch, that branch, is like a comfort zone. As long as I'm in that comfort zone, I don't even have the vision that there is more than that comfort zone. And we get stuck. We have a propensity to be afraid of what is going to happen. And that's why we have this fascination with wanting to know the future. When will I get married? When will I get unmarried? When will I die? And so on and so forth. That's why selling yantras is such a big business. You watch any Indian TV show or newspaper, you have any problems, you call this gentleman over here, he'll tell you what your future is, he'll send you a yantra, no problem. Only $500. Those people are laughing with their riches, and it's because we have this fascination with what's going to happen in the future. Should I tell you what's going to happen in the future? Will you give me $500 each, not per family, if I tell you? Here's what will happen. Whatever you think will happen may or may not happen. Those are the only two options. It may happen, it may not happen. What other choices are there? And when we simplify it that much, we stop being afraid. I've heard Guruji say, the worst that can happen is you'll die. We believe in reincarnation, big deal. You come back and you continue. And so we continue with our exploration of fear. Face everything. Face the weather, face exams, face finances, face traveling, face discourses, face discipline, face waking up in the morning, face going to sleep on time at night, and rise. And we're trying to do this in a controlled environment. For those who are new to Chinmay Mission, I get to interact with many people who are new, and they feel very comfortable. And I tell them why they feel comfortable. Because when you come here, this is a non-judgmental environment. As soon as you leave this ashram, you're constantly being judged. The model of car you drive, the zip code that you live in, how you combed your hair, if you have hair. Constantly being judged, from the oldest to the youngest. Vilasniji and I do many workshops on family affairs, understanding marriage and bullying and so on. Bullying does take place at a youth level, meaning high school students, but it actually happens much younger. This work that we're doing in a controlled environment means you're not here to be judged. And knowing that you're not here to be judged, create space in your mind to find that fear, to acknowledge the fear, to accept the fear, to appreciate the fear, and to adapt to the fear. But you need that space to think. Like a knot in one's shoes or one's pants, if it's too tight, and you have to go to the bathroom, it's the worst circumstance. You ask any little boy what a tragic experience of theirs when they're younger is when they have to go to the bathroom and by accident it got knotted twice. And their savior at that time is their mother. They're just looking all over for their mother. And what does she do? First she creates some space and then she can untie it. Correct? With the way we think too, we need this space where we're not judged, so we can think more clearly. When we create space in our minds, we come to understand the difference between challenges and problems. You type this into a dictionary or a thesaurus, and they'll both come up. What's a challenge? It's a problem. What's a problem? It's a challenge. They're both reference points for each other. But not in philosophy, not in the vision of Vedanta. Challenge plus purpose equals training. Challenge plus purpose equals training. Challenge minus purpose equals problem. Challenge minus purpose equals problem. So what's the difference between a challenge and a problem? Purpose. Someone who knows the purpose, this is my sadhana. This is a strong message that we focused on in the Understanding Marriage Retreat. If one knows the purpose of being a grahastha, there are no problems. Lots of challenges, no problem. But if one doesn't understand the purpose of being a grahastha, only problems. It's all about that purpose. And so, we now take on part of our workshop where you get to decide if what you're about to do is going to be a challenge for you or a problem. For me, definitively, it's a challenge because I don't have to do it. You do. I'll tell you one more humorous story related to this and then we'll get to our workshop. In a study group I was part of once, at the end of the study group, each person shares something that they learned from that study group. So a question, a quote, a revelation. And one older lady is talking about how her knees are hurting more, her grandchildren don't come to visit as often, she can't spend like she used to. So she's going on and on about this, and she literally looks up and says, "Why me?" Now the person next to her, I know this gentleman, he's a real firecracker of a personality. And I know that he's gonna say something really witty to her point, so I'm just smiling and waiting, waiting to hear this. This is how I get my sattvic joy. So when it comes to his turn, and he's smaller than this lady, and he goes, "Why not you? Why shouldn't you have problems? Who thinks that you're special? We all have our challenges." I was so happy when he said that. But we all have our own challenges, isn't it? That's what sometimes we say, kids, you don't know what it means to have challenges. They do know what it means to have challenges. They have their own challenges. When you give them, limit their screen time, that's a challenge for them. When you use your screens too much, that's a challenge for them. We all have challenges. Why? Wherever there is change, there will be challenges. And here we are in this jagat. Jayate, gacchati, tishtati, iti jagat. Jayate, that which is born. And as soon as it's born, gacchati, goes away. But in between, it's as if it, tishtati, stands. But this universe, this multiverse, is constantly changing. Samsara. Samsarati iti samsara. That which forever slips away. One day you're praised by this person, the next day they're gossiping about you. Slips away. Sharira. That which is forever perishing. I'd read somewhere, life is a terminal condition. No one can stop this body from dying. It's a terminal condition. So change in the multiverse, change in the society, change in the body, which means there's going to be challenges. But how do I face those challenges? Separates the weak and the strong. So now I get to see how strong you are. Oh.